How fun was that? I mean, great crowd, great atmosphere, great game.
Yeah, it was super exciting playing Frost. I mean, COVID last year, that's probably the biggest I've seen it since my freshman year, so it was just great to have a big crowd behind us for a big game, and they really helped us win that game.
You played those guys a month ago, and it didn't go anything like that. What was different this time?
I think just our effort and just our toughness in the game. They're super physical, and I think we handled that a lot better this game, and I think just executing what we want to do offensively and defensively.
Paige, were you guys just better, or did you make adjustments? Did you do some things differently scheme-wise this time?
Yeah, I think like Tori said, we just came out with a lot more effort and toughness and played more physical, and we were getting ready all week, just kind of game planning, and I think the team executed that really well today.
They're really good defensively. They're bigger than you. And in the first quarter, first half, it was obvious that they're making it tough for you to get inside. What did you do in the second half to kind of chip away at that a little bit?
If going inside, if it's there, otherwise just like looking back for either a dump pass or just finding the open player.
How big was it in the third quarter just when you kind of started getting momentum, you know, taking it from a 3-5 point lead, started to get 8-10 and the crowd got into it? It felt like you guys really sort of built on that.
We started getting some momentum there, which was really fun, but we knew we still had, you know, another half to play or quarter to play, so we had to keep pushing.
Tori, we talked a lot about the freshmen this year, but today was a big day, and they stepped up. You know, what did you think of their performance?
Yeah, you know, Timmy and Paige both played great. That's a hard atmosphere to play in. Even when it's at home, it can be a lot of nerves, a lot of adrenaline, but they both handled it great and really made a lot of big plays for us.
Did you guys change anything when Maya went out in the third quarter?
No, I don't think so. I think we just kind of came together and just made sure that we were all confident in each other still. You know, obviously Maya's a great player, but we needed to have some people step up, and that's what we did.
Tori, with this win, I mean, the Summit League regular season title is very much on the table and a lot of other things for you guys. Does that at all increase the pressure on you guys the rest of the way? Does it change your outlook at all, or do you just kind of keep moving forward?
I don't think it really changes like the pressure of it. I think that's what we've been working for all year. You know, we had a tough start to the year, and I think this whole time we knew what we were capable of, so we're just still working towards that and hope we can do it.
Well, a really important win for us. You know, you get into early February and you hope you have, you know, more important games coming later on, but this was a big, big game for us to continue to get to where we want to go in the regular season, so we really needed it. I thought second half we played outstanding. You know, we moved the ball well. Found some good matchups when we needed them to. Just did a better job, I thought, defensively at times. And that second half for us was outstanding. Our two freshmen are great. Paige and Haley Timmer came to play. You know, that second half in particular, they were you know, great. And I thought Tylee and Tori were really good in the second half too. But it's fun to see freshmen step up and make those kind of plays in those big moments.
Aaron, in the first quarter, you know, their defense in the paint kind of showed how dominant it can be, and it looked like maybe your girls would get frustrated, but obviously as the game wore on, you kind of found a way in. Did you make any sort of adjustments, or did you just kind of talk to them like, hey, let's keep chipping away and we'll find a way to get it going?
You know, I thought we tried to do too much in the first half after an initial ball screen. In the second half, we let ball screens happen, and then probably second and third pass after we had some spacing and movement, we were better there. I thought we tried to do a little too much early on, and after some of our ball screen action, that hurt us a little. On the other side of that, their defense is really good, so they just make it really difficult for everybody in there. But I thought we did a nice job against them defensively, too. I just really, you know, can look back, I'm sure, and find a couple things here or there. But, you know, when you play good teams, you're going to give up shots. You know, they have – their perimeter play is so good, they can just get a good shot every possession just on their own, you know, and they make it really hard for you. But I thought, you know, Ty did a good job defensively there in a real tough matchup against, you know, an elite player. But that second half, we were really good offensively, and certainly I thought good enough defensively too.
There were times where Paige is, you know, the smallest player, shortest player anyway on the court, and it seemed like she was the only one scoring at the basket. Did you talk to her about that? And did she kind of take it on her own? How did that sort of play out?
Well, that's where I think she, you know, after some initial action, she gave the ball up and got it back. So now she's approaching it differently. She's in kind of a triple threat where she can probably shoot it, drive either way. Everything in the first half with her was kind of just straight off the dribble, going sideways off the ball screen and now trying to find a gap. And in the second half, when she got the ball back and she's so quick and explosive off of some of their switches, you know, because she was attacking post players in those times. So she got it back in good matchups, I thought, and then really took advantage of it.
How big was the crowd to helping your team today?
Yeah, I mean, there's no place like it, and I'm a jackrabbit, so I can say that. People are going to think, you know, specifically of me, but, I mean, you literally cannot hear yourself talk to yourself on the bench. you know, I have to talk loudly to our assistant coaches about, you know, what's going on. When that crowd gets going, as they did in the second half, that's an amazing atmosphere. We're really lucky to have it.
Tori has been consistent all year, 16 points today. What did you think of her performance today?
You know, solid throughout, really good in the second half. I thought she really was assertive, going to the basket, a lot tougher mindset, hit a big three for us, free throws when we needed them. You know, Tori is also an elite player that plays on a team full of, you know, really elite players. So I think from game to game, you're going to see different people step up. Paige and Haley Timmer were great, but Tori was great too. You know, it's an enormous game. We can go out there and score 75 points, and Maya can score, you know, six. And that's not a critique of Maya. You know, when she's out there, she's such a presence. She draws so much attention that creates open shots for others. So we have a lot of balance this year, as much as I think, you know, we've had in a long, long time, and that's because those players worked really hard to be, you know, that good.
How much do you think your depth played into it once Maya picked up her fourth foul?
Well, I think it's helped that we've experimented throughout with a lot of lineups, playing Peyton and Callie together there in that third quarter. We got to that lineup a lot, and that's tough for other teams, especially if they're going to, you know, switch screens like that, I think. But then even on the perimeter, we can play versatile. Play Lindsay and Paige together. We can play Timmer and Tylee or Tori together. Tori can slide and play the four when we want her to. Yeah, I think our versatility, our length is really important.
Given how badly the first meeting went, how big is this win from a confidence standpoint? Because you're probably going to have to play him again.
You know, the first game was just disappointing. We did not play well, and they played well. So they were a part of why we didn't play well. In the first quarter, I think we were tied, if I remember right. So we had, I thought, two really poor quarters. Second and third really lost it for us, and the fourth just kind of played the game out, you know. But in those two quarters, I thought there were a lot of things that we could do better. You know, we were in foul trouble down there. We didn't manage it as well as I think we did here when we got in a little foul trouble. We ran a lot of different stuff today than we did down there. So, you know, we try and learn from every game, and that one gave us plenty of things to really think about. So that's a good thing, I guess.
What different stuff?
In that game we were really four out, one in stuff most of the game. You know, at that time, that's kind of what we were doing with Peyton Callie inside. We didn't have nearly the movement we have now or the spacing we have now. I thought today you saw a floor that was far more spread out than it was. I thought they got, they helped so well. We got them chasing some, you know, and that created some shots for us. So, yeah, we'll see. You know, we'll both have to look at this one and try and learn, and both try and get better going forward.